This is Willem Ziada, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film. And today I am thrilled to be speaking with the amazing singer, actor, dancer, content creator, the one and only Angie COCUZZA. But before we get to our interview, here's a sneak peek at her incredible talent.
Good. How are you?
Angie, I'm doing so much better now that I'm speaking with you. And I'm so excited the audience got a little sneak peek of one of your many talents, which is dancing. I want to know, Angie, first and foremost, where were you born and when did you realize that you had a love of the theater?
So I am a born and raised Jersey girl. And anybody who knows me knows that about me. I make it clear that I am from New Jersey. So I was born in Union, New Jersey, and we kind of moved around New Jersey as a kid, but my parents say that I came out of the womb singing, and they say that I was dancing on tables in restaurants. I was always taking the attention wherever I could.
As you do.
So, yeah, as you do, you know. But my parents are like, you know, we should probably get her into some lessons or something, because, you know, so she can have some outlet for this this crazy talent that she seems to be developing. So ever since I was little, I always loved singing. I always loved making people laugh. So that's really kind of what drew me to theater. And I also, you know, I love playing pretend. I never really grew up, I guess you could say. So I love theater because I get to get paid to play pretend.
That's amazing. Well, listen, I can relate. I mean, listen, I grew up outside of the city, similar to, but not in Jersey, but in Westchester, but I feel like we're probably equidistant to the city. I'm curious, were there any theater shows on Broadway when you were little, or one in particular, like when you saw it, you were like, I want to do that?
Well, I hate to be the basic theater girl, but Wicked truly was my awakening. I saw it and I was like, Alphaba, it's going to be me one day. Now that I've grown up and I've seen my talents, I know that I'm not so much an Alphaba per se, but I would still love to be, you know, in Wicked or a show like Wicked. But, you know, now that I've seen all the theater, my dream role right now, I would say, is like Dawn in Waitress. I would love to play Dawn. I love Sarah Bareilles too. So Wicked was a formative experience.
I think that's such a great role for you because it combines not only great singing and acting and dancing, but comedy. It's so hard to do comedy, Angie, and you're so funny. I want to know, do you have any comedic idols? Because for me, you have like an old school Lucille Ball, Carol Burnett thing going.
Yes. I love Carol Burnett. I love Lucille Ball. I also love Julie Louis-Dreyfus. She's one of my faves.
And oh my God, chameleon of a comedian. Like, you put her in any sitcom, she seems to win the Emmy.
Oh, yeah. But and just like, even watching, like, Seinfeld is on Netflix now. So even just watching like old Seinfeld, like, I'm just like, she's so funny. Like, I'm obsessed with her. And I also really love Amy Poehler and Tina Fey. Sketch comedy is something that I've really tried to, with my TikTok specifically, during the pandemic, I was like, yeah, there's nothing out there for me to do. You know, theater's dead as of right now, so I'll just write my own stuff, and that's what I started doing, and that's kind of the outlet that I have with my TikTok. So I would love to do more sketch comedy and things like that.
Well, let's lean into your TikTok for a moment, and actually before we go into it, I want to let our audience know, for more on the amazing Angie, you can read more about her right below this video. You know, throughout the pandemic, it seems that you kind of blew up on TikTok. You have tens of thousands of followers, and I love that as a creative artist, you took it upon yourself to create. And who knew? I mean, I'm sure your family's like, yay, where's the money, Angie? Because I know how Italian families are like, I know it, I get it. It's like, I get the likes, how are you gonna make money? I get it, so don't worry. You don't have to go through that right now, like therapy. That's what I do, God bless. But
yes, as we should,
Tens of thousands of followers. What do you love most about TikTok?
Oh, wow. I really love that it's a place where I feel like I can just create silly things that like come to my mind that I'm like, maybe some people will find this relatable and funny. I'll just put it up there, see if people like it. If they don't, they don't, you know. But at least I feel like it gives me an outlet to develop my crazy ideas and just
and work on your craft. It's almost as if the classes that your parents put you in to release all of this energy, you're now doing for yourself.
It's TikTok, like self-soothing.
Exactly. And on top of that, I'm really excited you're coming on board this really exciting new app, FENIX, and that it kind of combines all of the best of all of the social media platforms that are out there. One of the things that I just keep thinking about for you is FENIX has her own live stream where, you know, artists are now able to actually make money from ad revenue, whereas before they were making $0. I know that sounds like a crazy concept, artists making money to some people, but
never heard of it.
God bless. Too good to be true. But it's the truth of the matter with this app. And they have this amazing live stream feature that I can just see you doing like your own, I don't know, whether it's daily or weekly 5-minute like little sketch show that lives on the app and beyond. Anyway, my director hat, literally and figuratively on, is now directing your next move, Angie. You're welcome.
Hey, you know, I'll take it. We'll talk later.
Perfect. But Angie, you are a gem, and I'm so grateful for your time today. And I'm so grateful that we're connected now.
Yes, me too. This is amazing. Thank you so much.
Thank you.